In civil aviation, in Air India Express, the job responsibilities of a training personnel, I would say rather as a management personnel, it would be two types. One is purely technical, wherein you have the pilots, co-pilots, commanders and all. They undergo training where you just supervise them, because they are during the complete training, they're doing ground training, they're doing simulator training, they're doing aircraft training, so which is purely technical, and they are for the ground training, they are attached to ATO. So over there they go, they finish their ground subjects, all their technical subjects, performance subjects, navigation and special operations subjects. So after that, they come for simulator training, where they mostly do the non-normal procedures. They have to be familiar with all these procedures, which might not be feasible for them to practice in the aircraft. So they have to get used to it, because during emergency, they have to be prepared for such circumstances, which they have to practice in the simulator. So that again goes completely in the simulator training. The next is their aircraft training, where they get a real-time view of what they are supposed to be doing in the aircraft. So they undergo this aircraft training. So after that, they again have all these checks and all, and once they qualify all these kind of training, they are released online. They do a solo flight and then they are certified to fly online.
So we'll have an interaction today as to what we do and what career opportunities you can see to us. The training department, we can broadly classify into three categories, the working. The one can be training and delivery, second can be quality management, and last is regulations. So training and delivery, if you talk about that, it is not that once a pilot gets his license, he'll immediately be taken to an airline. We need to do a training in order to adhere to our ICAO and DGCA standards. So for that, the training department strives, plans the program, does the training for the pilot, and then once he's done all the training with regard to the regulations, we get him online for our operations. Second one will be, as I said, is our regulations. So the training is always based on ICAO and DGCA guidelines. These have been framed after taking into account all our international operations and our domestic operation, the safety that is related with it. So based on that, the DGCA has laid down regulations, and this we enforce by imparting the requisite training to the pilots. And next one is quality management. The quality management is, each training is effective only if it gets updated with time to time. So we may update our manuals, we update our procedures, our maneuvers and everything. So those all come under quality management.